Hi everyone, this is Dr. Neha Taneja, your mentor and guide for PSM but a public health specialist by profession. So today I've come up with a very important video, particularly with NEET PG around the corner. All your teachers ask you to study with full dedication, determination, devotion, which I'm sure you must be doing. But have you ever thought that in spite of being dedicated doctors, you might not clear NEET PG? Yes, that is quite possible. So this video, I'm going to tell you five top reasons why instead of being dedicated doctors, which you might think you are, or in reality you are, you might fail or you might end up not clearing NEET PG. So here are the top reasons. The first question I would like to ask all of you students: are you still caught in the pro-metric era? Now, what is this pro-metric era? So to put it in simple words, are you becoming highly obsessed with those lengthy questions, with those clinical oriented questions, with those controversial questions, conceptual questions that you might not be realizing, but you are making mistakes in marking those simple and easy questions? Okay, you are making a mistake in marking those questions. You're ending up making those wrong. All right, so pro-metric era was a time when difficult questions were rewarded higher marks, but now it's not like that. Okay, so the paper is going to be a mix of all the type of questions. So aap itne obsessed ho gaye ho ki paper aisa hi aayega that you're not realizing, but you are making mistakes in marking those simple easy questions. A person who's going to score will know that if I mark an easy question wrong, or if I mark a one-liner wrong, then my rank will definitely drop. Okay, so that might be one of the reasons. Second reasons: you are practicing enough MCQs, but are you focusing? Are you analyzing the answers that went wrong? Maybe you are not. You might tell yourself at the end that I practiced enough MCQs. फिर क्या गलत हो गया? गलत ये हो सकता है कि आपने जो MCQs practice करी, alright, you went on practicing without analyzing the answers, without kind of thinking why you got this answer wrong, which means you might not have learned the art of eliminating options. Okay, so you're just going on practicing MCQs without focusing or without analyzing the questions that you made wrong. Alright. Third point could be that you are not revising enough. Maybe you are caught up in this era right now that you have also become obsessed with these grand tests and all, ki tum sirf aur sirf grand test hi diye ja rahe ho, without focusing again, without analyzing, without revising the topic that you made a mistake in. Theek hai? You just want to do the grand test of this platform, that platform, itte sare to platforms hai. Okay, so you are like ki main uska question kar lu. The problem, a topper would be someone, or someone who gets a decent rank would be, okay, I've done, performed two grand tests. Let me first analyze those questions and answers, and let me then revise the topics. So the third point is, maybe you're not revising enough. You're just going on doing MCQs, aur us process mein tum memorize karte ja rahe ho answers, but if some other question comes, you might become caught up. All right, so if you are doing grand tests, you should do, of course, but don't get caught in that madness. Don't try to judge yourself with those grand tests. Learn to analyze those grand tests. They are meant for analyzing yourselves. Usse dekho kaun sa topic aapka weak tha jisme you failed to answer, and first revise that before moving to the next grand test. Okay, fourth point could be, do you know what are your weak subjects? Aapko pata hai aapke weak subjects kya hai? Even if you know them, have you left your weaker subjects for the end? Don't do that. With still 1 month to go, don't leave your weaker subjects, weaker topics for the end, because us time itna kuch ho jayega padhne ke liye, you will not be able to revise them. Even if you start revising, you will get demotivated. So please, if you know your weaker subjects right now, your weaker topics right now, practice them first, get over with them first, fir jao na asaan mein, wo to tumko aata hi hai. ठीक है. लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट, मे बी यू आर नॉट मेंटेनिंग योर टाइम मैनेजमेंट, योर स्पीड एंड एक्यूरेसी. वेन एवर यू डू और यू आर सॉल्विंग इनफ एमसीक्यूज, यू आर प्रैक्टिसिंग देम, मे बी यू आर नॉट डूइंग देम कीपिंग ट्रैक ऑफ द टाइम. पुट अ क्लॉक, set a timer whenever you are practicing MCQs. Don't do them without MCQs, even without a timer. Even when you are practicing them at home yourself, close your room, keep away your phone, set a timer and then practice MCQs. All right, that will help you judge your speed, accuracy and time. Tumne kitne time mein answer mark kiya sahi, kitne time mein galat, how much time did you end up, you know, reading the questions, all that during this last month is very, very important. Okay, so I hope these five things you're not doing, because if you're doing them, you need to come out of this era right now and keep revising, keep studying your content, at the same time keep practicing MCQs, but focus and analyze those MCQs where you are making a mistake, kaun sa topic galat hua, usko revise karo, phir hi aage padho. Alright, so maybe this video might help all of you. Alright, I hope this helps you. If you're still doing these mistakes, don't do that, and just don't be too much caught up with this pattern right now. Jo kar rahe ho wo karte raho. You have to conquer the topics, remember, not the pattern. All the very best students. I'll keep coming up with these small 5 minutes or 2 minutes videos every day maybe, all right, to keep you motivated and boost up. All right, thank you so much for watching. If you have any comments, put in the comment section below. Thank you so much.